put aside yourself and help others get ahead. Don't be obsessed with getting your own advantage. Forget yourselves long enough to lend a helping hand. Think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. He had equal status with God, but didn't think so much of himself that he had to cling to that, to the advantages of that status no matter what. Not at all. When the time came, he set aside the privileges of deity and took on the status of a slave, became human. Having become human, he stayed human. It was an incredibly humbling process. He didn't claim special privileges. Instead, he lived a selfless, obedient life, and then died a selfless, obedient death, the worst kind of death at that, a crucifixion. Because of that obedience, God lifted him high and honored him far beyond anyone or anything ever, so that all created beings in heaven and on earth, and even those long ago dead and buried, will bow and worship before Jesus Christ and call out in praise that he is the master of all, to the glorious honor of God the Father. Writes Paul to the Philippians, what is known as the Christ hymn. People say that Paul copied this as a hymn into this letter to talk about how Jesus Christ, who was God but didn't take that advantage to his own self to be able to remove himself from what he knew he had to face. Right? Jesus was God and could have not gone to the cross. Right? Yeah. It's simple. But God in Jesus came down to our level. He came level with you. He came level with me. Level with me. Has anybody ever said that to you before? I have people older people. Younger people, has anybody ever said that to you? Level with me. It's a phrase that means a couple different things, right? It can mean, tell me the truth. We use it in some mundane way, like, level with me. Does this all make me look fat? No, seriously. Or maybe a little bit more serious, level with me. Are you drinking again? Are you smoking again? Are you doing that thing that we talked about that you didn't say that you were going to stop doing? Or level with me. Do you really love me? Or the doctor? Level with me. How much time do I actually have left? Please tell me the truth. It's something that we say when we don't want to face the truth that's coming to us, right? We know the future holds something that we don't necessarily want to hear, so we say, level with me. It means tell me the truth. But it also means level with me, like I am now level with you. We are on the same level, right? We are on the same plane, we have the same status, we belong at the same plane. We're on the same plane, we're not higher than others, we're level with each other. And apparently in Philippi, there's an issue with some people thinking that they're better than other people. You don't have that in your life, do you? Some people in Philippi thought that they were better than other people. And today we see that same thing. People think they're better because they have more money, they have more educational credit, credentials, they have more positions, they have more power or influence over us, right? Have you seen it? We've all seen it. But does that make anybody any more special than anybody else? Simply because they gone to school longer, or they have more money, or they have power of influence over other people. At the foot of the cross, we're all on the same level. Some people think that they're not as good as other people because they don't have the educational credentials that other people have. They don't have as much money as other people have. They don't have as much power to yield over influence over other people. They think that they have a lower status. And that's not right either. At the foot of the cross, we're all level. We're all equal. Jesus came and made himself to be level with us. He emptied himself of everything that he could possibly hold. Every aspect of the deity that he could have. Every aspect of being God that he could to take on our form and our lives. To know what it is
to be exactly like us. And He stood on the same level as each and every one of us. And He knows what it's like in our day in and day out lives and the things that we face. He knows what you go through.
It reminds me, as I read the passage today, of a Gaither vocal song. It's a "He Came Down to My Level." That's actually the name of the song. It's a wonderful song. The verse, the chorus is, "He came down to my level when I couldn't get up to Him. With a strong arm, He lifted me up to show me what living is. He'll come down to your level if you'll open up the door. He wants to make your life worth living. That's what He came down for."
Jesus came down and emptied Himself completely to know what it's like to be you. So don't let anybody look down on you. Don't look down on anybody else. Because at the foot of the cross, we're all the same. We're all one. That's why He came. Help us see each other as He sees.